1847 in Milan, Ohio. I had great parents. My father Samuel worked very hard in the shingle mill, grain, and timber business. My mother Nancy was my biggest inspiration. After some trouble I had in school, my mother took it upon herself to school me at home. She helped me develop my love of reading and my passion for experimenting. I was a very curious child, so I loved doing different experiments. I even set up a lab in the basement of our house to do my experiments. I got my first job at the age of 12. I wanted to be more independent from my parents, so I got a job as a grain truck driver, selling newspapers to the passengers. Soon, I was also selling candy and seasonal vegetables. When I was 14, I decided to start my own newspaper. So I set up a lab and a printing press in one of the spare homes. While working for the railroad company, I became fascinated by the telegraph machine, and I began hanging around the telegraph offices, watching the operators sending and receiving messages. One day, I saw a three-year-old boy playing on a track, and a train was coming toward him. I was able to save this boy from the oncoming train. His father was a telegraph operator. As a reward for saving his son's life, he taught me how to use a telegraph machine. I soon became the telegraph operator, and then I set off to be a train telegraph, working wherever the wages were highest. My first gardening adventure was an electric railway. I hoped that the supplies would be used by the state government in the election, but the lawmakers were not interested. This failure taught me a valuable lesson. I decided that I would never again invent something that people did not want. I opened my lab in Menlo Park, New Jersey, to be devoted entirely to its people. Many people call this lab an invention factory. I wanted my team and I to design new machines and devices to solve problems. I love working. I usually work 18 hours per day. On many occasions when I was in the middle of an invention or an experiment, I would just stay in the lab for days. On end and in consistent sleep, I would just take cat naps as I needed. My idea for inventing the phonograph came from my wish to improve Alexander Graham Bell's telephone. The biggest problem with the Bell's telephone was that the sound transmitter was weak. A caller had to shout in order to be heard at the other line. I was sure I could come up with a way to make the telephone sound louder and clearer. As I was working on improving the telephone, I thought, the human voice could travel over wires, and there should be a way to record the sound so it could be listened to later. And the idea for the phonograph was born. To my surprise, the machine worked the very first time. I recorded the words to the line, Mary had a little lamb. I wanted to create a safe, mild, and inexpensive electric lamp to use everywhere. People were still using candles, oil lamps, or gas lamps to light their homes at the time. After almost a year of hard work and many failures, we found the red filament to put inside the light bulb. In December 1879, I was able to show the world my invention by lighting the Menlo Park streets. In 1901, my family and I started to spend our winters in Florida to get away from the cold of the north. We found this quiet small town in the west coast of Florida called Fort Myers. The people were very welcoming. I wanted to return the community's affection toward me and my family. So I brought 2,000 royal palms from Cuba to plant along the main road. I continued to travel around the world collecting many kinds of plants and trees for my experiments in bringing these plants to Fort Myers. I was determined to find a natural source of growth. I also built Florida's first modern concrete swimming pool in my backyard, which we enjoyed very much. I would say my greatest achievement were the inventions of the phonograph, the electric light bulb, the electric generator, and the movie camera. I am hoping that one day these inventions will pave the way for the future innovations by other inventors.